turn his mic up. Man, are you blessed, Saints? Man, I can't tell a lie. Man, I'm in love with this ministry. Amen. In love with this. Yeah. Who could ask for anything more? Amen. Amen. Oh my goodness, I'm excited. Amen. In the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. Going to do some challenging today. Going to challenge you in the Word. Hallelujah. Saints, I want to encourage you to do the best, be the best, walk in the best, confess the best. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. But I am totally proud of this ministry.
Amen.
In the name of Yahshua. We have never received the growth that we've received in this past week on Facebook. We've got about 100 new friends in the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. We have never had this influence. We've never had this power. We've never had this much warfare, this much increase.
Amen.
In the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. And I want to call them the people who helped usher it in. First Armor Bearer Troy. We got a word to come up against Pastor Bull. Very bold, unrepentant, unrepentant, unapologetic. We're going to call up Minister Lamont. In the name of Yahshua. My whole neighbor. My brother in Yahshua. I'm going to call up Pastor Kelvin. He's not here. His wife is here. She's standing for him. Yeah. I'm going to call up Mr. Christo. In the name of Yahshua. Very, very fierce. Very, very confident. But I have a great love for this house.
Amen.
Amen. When you move on a word, you make people uncomfortable.
Yes.
When you move on a word in the name of Yahshua, you are Christ-like. Amen.
Amen.
You are Christ-driven in the name of Yahshua.
Amen.
I'm very, 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 very proud in the name of Yahshua. Good seeing you, brother. I mean, very, very proud of what is taking place in the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. I salute you.
Amen. Amen.
I'm very, very proud. Let me tell you something. When you run into people with true testimonies, amen, people who truly are from the streets know you can't play both sides. But when you're with sold out people, hallelujah, it makes a difference. I mean, it shows. Hallelujah. But this week, hallelujah, has been a great, mighty week in the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah, I love you greatly. Amen. I'd like Minister Lawan and Oliver Barry Troy to remain standing in the name of Yahshua. Maybe you can stand a little bit on this side so we can get the board. Amen. But today is going to be a very different day.
Amen.
In the name of Yahshua.
Amen.
Today's message. You have not so learned Christ. You have not so learned Christ. Amen. He's important. Forgive me, but I'm on fire.
Amen.
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 Saints, we're greatly blessed. We have Prophet Kwame's grandmother here.
Amen.
She didn't know her grandbaby correct. She was like, you know, the head, like, whoa. They're telling you, pick up and put it in the center. She might sneak me on the box. Right? Also, Hallelujah, Minister Monique's father is here.
Yeah.
You have not so learned Christ, amen. Sometimes vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor in Yahweh's house.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
In every house you have vessels of honor, and in every house you have vessels of dishonor. Amen. I apologize for my scrappy voice. Amen. I usually drink some tea before service. But then again, I was worshiping You know, when you can't sing, you can shout. Yeah. I can't sing, but I can shout. Yeah. You have not so learned Christ. Vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor in Yahweh's house. You ready? Hallelujah. A word to cut the hardness of heart. Amen. Saints, what makes our ministry different is that our ministry, we're very bold, we're very unapologetic about the word, about the stance of Yahweh, and about what he's called us to do. But the Bible is very explicit that in every house there is vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor. But that being true in the name of Yahshua, also, hallelujah, in the second book of full of Christian doctrine, the first book is the book of Romans, the second book is Ephesians. Let us turn to Ephesians chapter 4, verse 2. Hallelujah. You can have people who spend their whole life in church and still not learn Christ. Are you with me, saints? I have a lot to say this morning. Hallelujah. Let us receive the tithe and offering along the prayer request. Amen. I'm very, very proud of what we have built. Very, very proud of this ministry. Hallelujah. I will defend this ministry in any form in the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. In any form. But I will defend my friends, and my friends will defend me. Amen. In the name of Yahshua. Yeah. I hear you, Minister Jimmy. In the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. But I want to challenge you this morning that in the book of Ephesians, amen, hallelujah, Apostle Paul is very bold to tell them, you have not so learned Christ. Right. Amen. In the name of Yahshua. Very, very, very important. In the name of Yahshua. Amen. Hallelujah. Once again, in the book of Ephesians, hallelujah, it is the second doctrinal letter. The first doctrinal letter to Christian saints is the book of Romans. Amen. Hallelujah. Ephesians is the second doctrinal letter, amen, which pictures the believers as sitting together with Christ in heavenly places. Amen. It contains the highest forms. Everyone say it contains the highest forms. Of church truths.
Church.
Amen. Hallelujah. Once again, it is the second doctrinal letter. The first doctrinal letter is the book of Romans. Amen. In the book of Romans, it sets forth the believer's relationship with Christ's death, burial, and resurrection. Whereas Ephesians is the second doctrinal letter, which pictures the believers as sitting together with Christ in heavenly places. Amen. Can you just write Ephesians? Positions Christians with sitting together with Christ in heavenly places. And this is very, very, very important in the name of Yahshua. When I came home from Shabbat service, Holly, it was pretty late. We hang tough. So I got home maybe like 4 a.m., you know. And understand that fellowship begins after church, not
before. Amen.
So when I got home, Yahweh spoke to me. And he said very explicitly, I told my wife, he said, you will never have another financial problem as long as you're on the face of the earth. But I knew it was Yahweh, and then Yahweh began to show me writing my books.
Amen.
And my books being in great demand.
Yes.
In the name of Yahshua. And my books bringing in millions. And then he showed me building 3 houses in New Jersey.
Amen.
One in Newark. And the other two, he hasn't given me a location. And Yahweh says, everything that you do, Holly, is going to set a testimony.
Amen.
Very, very, very important. Very, very different Sunday service today.
Amen.
I mean, make sure you're part of the blessing.
Amen.
Of the miracle. In the name of Yahshua. Are you with me, saints?
Amen.
I come forth. Hallelujah. In the name of Yahshua. Saints, it's very important for you to move on the word that Yahweh gives you in the name of Yahshua in order to bring in great miracles and wonders. I'm going to pray over the top and walk through the stretch of your hand. Father, I boast on you. I boast on your name. I boast on your vision. Father, I thank you and praise for each and every person who came into agreement with what you told them to do today concerning tithe, offering, and prayer requests. Father, I loose a blessing. I loose a miracle. I call them, Father God, being multiplied to each and every person who gave, Father God. Increase them a millionfold. Father, we loose an anointing of the hearts of the leadership. Whereby, Father God, they will build, Father God, according to your kingdom, according to your kingdom principles, Father God, so they can walk in your wealth, in your knowledge, and goodness. In Christ Yahshua's name, amen. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father God. You have not so learned Christ. Let us remember that the epistles were written to Christians. So here it is that Apostle Paul is telling Christians, you haven't so learned Christ. So he's telling Christians who have been sinning underneath his teaching, for those of you who like to study, Apostle Paul spent more time in the Ephesus church than the other church. It's believed that he spent 3 years in the Ephesus church, and the Ephesus church was the largest church that he built. It is believed that the Ephesus church had over 100,000 people. Amen. Once again, over 100,000 people. For those of you who like to study, hallelujah, Timothy was the bishop of this assembly. Apostle Paul was the apostle over the assembly, hallelujah. This is also the assembly, hallelujah, of Christ's mother, Mary. Amen, hallelujah. And also the assembly of Apostle Yah. Amen. So you have to understand that this house that he built had a great and mighty influence. But yet, this house, hallelujah, which the doctrinal basis is, it positions Christians to sit together with Christ, in other words, sharing power with Christ. He comes back to them and he says, you have not so learned Christ. Meaning that people can sit all their lives in church and still not learn Christ. Meaning that if Yahweh has vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor in his house, then Bet Hashem Yahweh has vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor in our house. We can't have something not in our house that Yahweh has in his house. I need you with me in the name of Yahshua. But at the same token, what a lot of people do not understand about Bet Hashem Yahweh is that Yahweh gives Bet Hashem Yahweh a word sharp enough to cut through a hardened heart. So today we want to teach about a hardened heart. Hallelujah. What produces a hardened heart and what are the effects of a hardened heart. Hallelujah. Our ministry, what we do is we come up against hard hearts and we take out a blade and we go straight in. Unapologetic.
Yes.
Amen. Once again, we take out a blade and we go straight in. Unapologetic. Because it is the ministry of Christ. Now, I want you to understand this. Listen. Now, I was meditating on this. I want you to listen, Minister Ron, in the name of Yahshua. Oh, my goodness. Yahweh never uses leaders to bring change.
Teach.
Yahweh always bypasses leaders and goes directly to the people.
Amen. Amen.
We see this is true with Abraham. He bypassed everybody and went straight to Abraham. We see that this is true with Hallelujah, Joseph. We see this is true, hallelujah, with Gideon. Gideon said, who am I that Yahweh should use me? My father doesn't even recognize me. Hallelujah. I'm considered a bastard. Yeah. But yet Yahweh says, I chose you to bring deliverance.
Amen.
We see the same thing is true with Samson.
Right. Yeah.
I need you with me. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Here it is, hallelujah, Samson's mother and father minding their business, and Christ comes and gives them a word. We know it's Christ because they said, what is your name? And when you interpret what the Hebrew says, he said, what is my name to you, seeing that it is wonderful? Amen? In the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. But here it is that Yahweh always takes people who are not in leadership. Hallelujah. He takes people from ordinary people when he calls them into leadership in order to bring change.
Amen.
In other words, when Yahweh came in and he ushered in the New Testament, he bypassed all the Pharisees and the Sadducees. For those of you who like to study, it was the Sadducees who were the scribes. It was the Pharisees who oversaw the temple. So here it is that Yahweh totally bypassed them and went directly to the people. What we see taking place today is Yahweh is bypassing pastors, apostles, prophets, teachers, evangelists. He's totally bypassing them and going directly to the people. Where the pastors and the fivefold ministry are saying, his name is not important. His name is of no concern. Amen. They're saying his name is not important, even to the point that they will admit and understand what they're admitting. They're admitting that they don't know Yahweh's name.
That's right.
It even goes further. When you have someone in the fivefold ministry who says, well, according to Jewish tradition, the name was so holy that it was not spoken,
right,
which is unscriptural because you cannot carry out sacrifices in the temple without knowing Yahweh's name. And the temple wasn't destroyed until 70 AD. I need you to listen. And also, when you go into studies, the Encyclopedia Judaica, they totally displace that. They don't believe in that nonsense.
Right.
But when you have a pastor who makes the argument, and I need you to listen, that his name is too holy to say, recognize what that pastor is admitting. That pastor or that person in the fivefold ministry is admitting that they never heard Yahweh say his name. There is no one in this Bible who was called who didn't hear his name. Not some. Everyone who was called. They were called in his name and they prophesied in his name. You can't represent Yahweh without knowing Yahweh, and you can't know Yahweh without knowing his name. So you have to understand how what is taking place, Ben Hashem Yahweh. We have pastors who are admitting, I don't have a personal relationship with the name Yahweh. They're admitting I have a personal relationship with the English name Jesus, so they can only walk in the anointing of that name. But they cannot surpass that name. They can't go deeper than that name. Holy Spirit. In other words, we have people who spend so much time in Christianity, but in a Christianity that comes from England and not a Christianity that comes from Christ.
Right.
Here it is, that in the book of Ephesians, the second doctoral letter, which positions us to sit together with Christ, Apostle Paul is saying, you have not so learned Christ.
Yes.
Father, you are magnified. This is Ephesians chapter 4. Bear with me, saints, in the name of Yahshua. I'm very excited.
Amen.
I'm very, very much thankful for what Yahweh has done and is doing in the name of Yahshua. I have a lot of prophecies in me today in the name of Yahshua.
Amen.
First thing, we know in part and we prophesy in part.
Amen.
Understand, in the name of Yahshua, because of Armor Bearer Troy, because Armor Bearer Troy coming up very powerfully against Pastor Grove, and I stand by everything I said.
Right.
I'm a student of the Word.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And being a student of the Word, I clearly said that was a textbook word. But I didn't know he was reading from a textbook. But I knew it was a textbook word in the name of Yahshua. Hallelujah. And I'm very proud of my Yahweh. I'm very proud of my ministry. Very proud of Armor Bearer Troy, even though I was blamed for Armor Bearer Troy doing what he was doing. Actually, Armor Bearer Troy, you were insulted too, as if you don't have a brain, as if you don't hear from the Holy Spirit, as if you're some wind-up dog. I don't have any friends that are wind-up dogs. That's not what I have to say. I'm very bold about that. Very, very bold about that. Give me a moment in the name of Yahshua. Come on. Oh, my goodness, come on. Ephesians chapter 4. Saints, I'm a fighter. But something that I will not compromise. I will not compromise my Yahweh.
Amen.
You with me? That's something that I will not compromise. In the name of Yahshua. Ephesians 4:20, very speedily. It reads, I'm here, minister. Minister, I want you all to hear from the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Because of what Armor Bearer Troy did, I got a few phone calls from the fivefold ministry. Hallelujah. Everyone who called me was in agreement with the name.
Amen.
And everybody who called me was in agreement with Armor Bearer Troy.
Amen.
Though they might not have started out in agreement with me, by the time that they called me, they were in agreement. Which once again shows the miracles and the wonders of Yahshua.
Amen.
Ephesians 4:20 says, but you have not so learned Christ. The word have is the Greek word manthano. Manthano. Everyone say manthano. M-A-N-T-H-A-N-O. Manthano. It means to learn. It means to be appraised. It means to increase in one's knowledge. It means to hear. It means to be informed. It means to learn by use and practice. Everyone say to learn by use.
Learn by use.
And practice.
And practice.
Very, very, very important. I want you to listen. But you have not manthano. You have not learned. You have not appraised. You have not increased in your knowledge. You have not been informed. You have not put to use into practice. It also means, manthano means to be in the habit of. Once again, to be in the habit of. I was meditating on this. Do you know everyone who says, I was saved in the name of Jesus, I was healed in the name of Jesus, and refuses to admit the name Yahshua? Do you know what that means? What it means is that they stay in their old anointing.
Right.
If that would have happened, no one would have ever left the law of Moshe. If that would have happened, they would talk about, I received miracles under the law of Moshe. I received the miracles of Elijah. I received the miracles of Jeremiah. I received the miracles of Elisha. Amen. I received the miracle of the prophets. Amen. They would have never received Christ. But according to Scripture, whenever the Heavenly Father reveals something new, you have to walk in what's new, or you're left behind. The Bible says how you can no longer trust in the old covenant because it has been fulfilled. How you only have salvation in the new covenant. So you have to move into the new covenant, but yet we will run into people who have spent all that time and still have not been manthano. They haven't learned. They haven't been appraised. They haven't increased in their knowledge. They haven't learned in use and practice. They're stuck exactly what they're in. In other words, they were taught Jesus came, Jesus died, Jesus rose, and now sits at the right hand of the Father. And never takes the time to ask themselves a simple question, how did he end up with an English name? Amen. Meaning that they have not so learned Christ. Amen. I need you to listen to me in the name of Yahshua. Once again it says, but you have not so learned. Learn once again is manthano. You have not learned Christ. Christos. Translated to the English, I want you to put up there, is anointed. So what you have people who have been under the anointing, in the anointing, and still they have not learned from the anointing. They have not become one with the anointing. Amen. In the name of Yahshua. Now, what's so powerful about this text begins, hallelujah, in such a simple form. Let us turn to verse 1. Are you with me, saints?
Amen.
And therefore, the prisoner of Adonai beseech you that you walk worthy of your vocation, wherever you were called. You've got to walk worthy of your vocation. With all lowliness and meekness, with long-suffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the spirit of the bond of peace. There is one body, one spirit, even if you're called in one hope of your calling, one Adonai, one faith, one baptism, one Elohim, and Father of all, who is above all, in all, through all, and in you all. All that oneness, how it magnifies that one name. But yet within all of this, they have not learned Christ. I need you with me for a moment. That being true, don't be shocked when you run into fivefold ministers who have not learned Christ, or fivefold ministers who say, I know the name Yahweh, I know the name Yahshua, but they don't use it.
Right.
Whenever you know something and you don't use it, what you're saying is not important to you. But the thing is, it's not whether or not it's important to you, it's whether or not it's important to the Word. It's whether or not it's important to Scripture in the name of Yahshua. This, Allah, is what makes the mandate in the name of Yahshua, because if it's important to the Word, Allah, then we have to stand on it. What we know about Moshe is the Bible says that Moshe was learned in all the wisdoms of the Egyptians. But yet, in all the wisdoms of the Egyptians, Allah, that didn't negate what Yahweh taught. In other words, whenever Yahweh comes into your life, he adds something to you.
Amen.
There's something wrong when you use your knowledge to fight Yahweh.
Amen.
There's something wrong when you use your knowledge to fight that which is true. And what I love about the name Yahshua is that it's spiritual.
Right.
What do I mean by that it's spiritual? It's spiritual by the emphasis that people don't like it and don't even know why they don't like it. So you know the name Yahshua is spiritual because people will not like the name and won't even know why they're not liking the name in the name of Yahshua. But this being true in the name of Yahshua, we have to understand that Yahweh's word is so strong, so powerful, that it blows away the hardness of heart. Are you with me, saints? Father, I magnify you, you praise. Let us turn to 2 Timothy chapter 2. 2 Timothy chapter 2. Easy quarter. 2 Timothy 2, verse 20. Now we're about to get a little bit deeper.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, baby. 2 Timothy chapter 2. Amen. Put your hands together for the minister, saints. We have a new minister now. We love you. We thank and praise Yahweh that you are here. I need you listening in the name of Yahshua. I have so much to say.
Amen.
Saints, Yahweh is adding to our ministry.
Yeah.
And you can just look around and see that Yahweh is adding.
Yes.
You can see exactly what he's adding and what he's putting together.
Amen.
You can see that every time a new soul comes in, it takes us to a whole new level. And new souls have a great zeal.
Yes.
Whereby the scripture says, I'll lay the last first and the first will be last.
Amen.
I have so much to say. So now we have to touch on vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor before we get into the hardness of heart.
Yes.
Amen. Because we have a ministry that is called to operate on the hardness of hearts.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. And when you're called to operate on the hardness of hearts, the first thing you have to cut is people's feelings.
Yes.
Holly, so this ministry was called to hurt you. This ministry was called to hurt you. Amen. And I think what people fail to realize that your salvation was not free.
Yes.
He was hurt for you to be saved.
Yes.
There was a hurt that came in. Not only was he hurt, hallelujah, but he was sacrificed for you to be saved.
Yes.
So there's a hurt that comes in. So there's a truth. So you have to understand, when people don't want to get hurt, stand up, Minister Princess. When people don't want to stand up, Minister Ron, when people don't want to get hurt, they put shields over their heart. People put shields on their heart so you don't hurt their heart. But when a person puts a shield on their heart, what they're doing is they're hardening their heart. You have a lot of people, they're so determined not to be hurt again that they have hardened their heart. When you harden your heart, nothing good and nothing can come in. So we have people who harden their hearts. So Bet Hashem Yahweh, we've been given a ministry. We've been given the ministry of the double-edged sword.
Yes.
Amen. The first thing we've got to do, Holly, is break open that hardness of heart.
Yes.
But why are people walking in the hardness of heart? Usually what people do, especially in this ministry, let me tell you what people do in this ministry. Weak people tend to come together.
Yes.
Amen. I feel they're talking about you, they're talking about me. Come on, God. They just come together and like, yeah, we're going to stick together.
Yeah.
Y'all not gonna mess with us. I mean, I've always been too cool for that. I've never in my life wanted to be around people who didn't want to be around me.
Yeah.
I never wanted to impress people who didn't want to be around me. Why do I want to be around somebody who wants to be around me? Amen. In the name of Yahshua. That's just crazy in the name of Yahshua. Amen. But what people in this ministry do, they come together, but they don't ask themselves a simple question. Did Yahweh call you here? If Yahweh didn't call you here, scram, get out. Amen. Hallelujah. We live streaming, right? Good. Listen. There are millions of churches out there. Bet Hashem Yahweh is not the only right church. Amen. And yes, you can say Jesus and go to heaven. We never said you couldn't. Amen. What we said in the name of Yahshua is that Jesus is not his name. People say, well, why does Yahweh honor the name Jesus? He honors his word.
Amen.
By his stripes you're healed.
Yes.
Some of you don't like it. Doesn't make a difference what name you use. The word says, by his stripes you were healed. The word says, if you call on him, he'll save you. Even if you call on him in ignorance, if he knows you're calling on him, he's going to save you because he honors his word. Hallelujah. But once you are taught the truth, you're commanded to walk in the fullness thereof. Hallelujah. Let me move forward fast in the name of Yahshua. Also, verse 2 Timothy 2:20 says, but a great house. Everyone say a great house. But a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. Amen. In other words, if in Yahweh's house he has vessels of honor and dishonor, then we too have vessels of honor and dishonor in our house. The Greek word for honor is tame. Tame. T-I-M-E. Tame. It means a value by which the price is fixed. Amen. There are vessels of honor and some vessels of dishonor. A vessel of dishonor is atime. Whenever you put alpha in front of a word in Greek, it becomes a negative. A-T-I-M-I-A. It means dishonor. It means disgrace. So we have vessels of honor and vessels of disgrace. But what does the word say? All things work together for good. Whoever's out to hurt you, when you serve Yahweh, Yahweh turns it around that it helps you.
Amen.
Are you with me? In the name of Yahshua. You can't have it anyway. Vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor. So what we have to understand, and I need you to hold on for a moment. How is it that Yahweh bypassed the Pharisees and the Sadducees, and you think that Yahweh changes now, whereby he won't bypass pastors, prophets, teachers, evangelists, and apostles? He will bypass them. He will bypass them the same way that he bypassed the others, because they denied him. Because they boldly said, we don't know you. We don't know your name. In the Hebrew culture, to speak someone's name, you speak their presence. That's how come Christ said, wherever two or three are gathered in my name, I am in the midst. In the Hebrew culture, what they do is they light a candle, representing those who passed, recognizing that those who passed are still alive. I'm going to tell you something. I want y'all to do this and listen. Go to Barnes & Noble and buy books on the Passover. They're very small pamphlets. Hallelujah. Within it, you'll have the prayers. Hallelujah. And you'll have the ceremony. And you'll see in the Passover that all those scriptures pertain to Christ. So every Passover meal, Jews are constantly confessing the scriptures over Christ. But yet, hallelujah, the word says they have a zeal but not according to knowledge. They don't even know how what they're confessing in the name of Yeshua, because they have not so learned Christ. That being true, we have some people today who have been in the anointing for a long time, but they've never learned the anointing, hallelujah, because they have not valued themselves.
Right.
It's not that Yahweh made you a vessel of dishonor, it's that you walk as a vessel of dishonor. And you walk as a vessel of dishonor, hallelujah, when you don't walk in the fullness of who and what Christ called you to be and do. Amen. Now let's get into the fullness of the word. Let us turn to Exodus chapter 7. I need you with me.
Amen.
Exodus chapter 7. I'm going to begin with verse 1. Shemos 7. So I have, so many people follow us on Facebook. I have, I think my third grade teacher, she's Jewish. Her name is Jill Freed, and she follows us on Facebook a lot. Majority of people who follow us on Facebook will never, ever click like. I'll say this, I said it before, I will say it again. The number one TV show is a reality TV show.
Yes.
My Facebook page is a reality show. Hallelujah. My Facebook page is a reality show in the name of Yahshua, because who I'm ministering to and who I'm called to win. Hallelujah. As in the Word, as in the Bible, I never seek to win the person I am debating.
Right.
I am never seeking to win the person that I'm arguing with. I'm seeking to win those who read. Every argument Christ had is written, now it's called scripture. Every argument he had with the Pharisees and Sadducees is now scripture. Christ didn't hide any of that, it's all open. But with that scripture, through that argument, we have a teaching lesson. But we always see within scripture is that the Pharisees and the Sadducees always tried to outsmart Christ. Usually before he answered them, he called them a name. Hallelujah. He called them a hypocrite. He called them a name. He was very direct. Christians today don't like being direct. The reason they don't like direct is because you put their sin on front street. But what I can't understand is there's something different about people who come to church today. When I went to church and I was doing my dirt, I laid low. But people now who come do their dirt, they put it all out. They stick it all out. You know, for some reason they feel led, it's their job to rebuke the bishop. No, when I was sleeping around, when I was whoremonging, I came to church to get saved. I came to get church to get saved, not to rebuke the pastor. But today you have people come on with a homosexual spirit. Yeah, I'm a homosexual. What you gonna do about it, folks? If you gonna be all bold about it, I'm gonna rebuke you. If you gonna be all bold about it, I'm gonna rebuke you today, yes, sure, because I know what the house represents. But you know, in this day and age, we have people who will flaunt their sin. Hallelujah. But there's something wrong when you flaunt your sin, hallelujah, in Yahweh's house. Because the Bible says, judgment starts first at Yahweh's house. So, when I was going to the love of Jesus, and when I was going to love Jesus, I knew the name Yahshua, but I never felt that it was my job to go to Pastor Jason Alvarez and say, Pastor Jason Alvarez, I'm going to teach you the word. You see, the Holy Spirit never sent me to a church to teach my pastor word. The Holy Spirit sent me to a church to learn. The Holy Spirit sent me to a church in the name of Yahshua because there was some type of impartation that had to be put into my life. When I went to David DeMola's church, I didn't go to David DeMola's church to teach him the name Yahshua and tell him, you're in sin, you're in error. No, the Holy Spirit sent me there to sit under his anointing that I might learn in the name of Yahshua. When Yahweh sent me to Apostle David Allen's church, I didn't go to Apostle David Allen's church trying to set things in order. No, I was sent there to learn. Because I recognize you got people who've been sitting in church all their life who still have not learned Christ. Like this church, where people will sleep around, whore around, and feel like it is their job and their duty to rebuke me. I used to go to go-go bars. I used to sleep around. You with me? Amen. But I sure ain't come in church. Where does that mentality come from? Where does that mentality? Is there no fear of Yah? People who do such things, they have not learned Christ. But let me tell you what's taking place. And this is what a lot of people don't understand. Vessels of honor and vessels of dishonor, I don't care who you are, there's certain people that I can't win. Only you can win because you were designated to win. Only you can win them because you were designated to win. Only you can win them, Gabby, because you were designated to win. But when you turn your back on Christ, there are people you were called to minister to who will never get ministered to because you're not walking in obedience, meaning that you're not going to be what Yahweh called you to be. And whenever you're not what Yahweh called you to be, it's because there's a hardness of heart. I'm going to tell you what I love about this ministry. What I love about this ministry, you will have people who come here for 10 years, leave, and then they got to come up with an excuse why they wasted 10 years here. I didn't waste 10 years. Okay, so you were out with the cuckoo bird, so it took you 10 years to find out I was crazy. What I find so amazing, we have still some crazy people here today who agree with the crazy people who left. And I need to know, what's your crazy notion for being here? And I'm the one. Exodus chapter 7. I need you with me. Exodus 7, verse 1 through 5. Verse 2. Reason follows. And Yahweh said unto Moshe, see, I have made thee an Elohim to Pharaoh.
Yes.
Write that on the board.
Yes.
Yahweh will make you an Elohim to your enemies, that they will eat, drink, and sleep in. I know this. I use it on Facebook all the time. People will say to me, why are you so insulting? I'll answer something I'll say laugh out loud. Because I've learned something, Danny. I can't lose. I can't lose.
Come on.
When you can't lose, you're bold.
Amen.
I know that I can't lose. Amen. It's already been predetermined.
Come on,
Minister Joe.
Amen.
It's already been predetermined that I'm going to win. I need you to listen to me. Are you listening for a moment? Listen to what's taking place on Facebook. We have pastors. I mean, any way you put the argument, that's one thing when you're led by the Holy Spirit, doesn't make a difference how you put the argument you go in. First they come on and say, oh, you guys believe in the sacred name. Well, if we believe in the sacred name, is that saying that Jesus' name is not sacred? And if Jesus' name is not sacred, why are you spending all your time defending it? Why would you defend something that's not sacred? I need you with me for just a moment. But what I find amazing is this, and I need you listening to me. I mean, since you have to understand, how when I first started ministering, I used to rent out a club. No, I used to rent out the church across from Shatters on Central Avenue. And I used to preach to nothing but empty chairs back in 93, 94, 95, 96. I mean, but I was very faithful. Again, I was preaching to these empty chairs. But look, the chairs aren't empty anymore. If I was faithful, preaching, studying, preaching to empty chairs, how much more faithful am I now going to be,
yes.
Minister Crystal, that people are sitting in the chair with a testimony. I need you to listen. Come on. So here it is. Come up here, Elder Steve. Come up here, Eliah. Yeshua. Hallelujah. Issachar. Stand over there. Steve got that slope on his listen. A lot of people do not know the history of our ministry.
Amen.
A lot of people don't know the history of our ministry. I mean, when we first started ministry, I knew the name Yahweh and Yahshua since I was born because my grandfather ministered that name, and that name has always been a reality to me. When this ministry was started, we ministered in the name of Jesus.
Yes. Come on. Yes.
We sang in the name of Jesus. And my grandfather's church asked me to come up and teach and preach. His church is in Richmond, Virginia. And I said, we're going to go and preach. I said, but as we go and preach, I'm going to teach on the name. So I taught on the name. And we went to preach. When we came back, hallelujah, lift your hands, Eliah, representing his mother, Camille, she was like, no, 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 Bishop, this is wrong. We have to stay on what we learned. So Sister Camille Green was very instrumental.
Yes, she was.
I need you with me.
Amen.
Eli, you have a calling in this house.
Amen.
And people who know the history hate you for the call.
Yes.
They hate you for the calling in the name of Yahshua because the calling was birthed unto you. I remember when his mother came up with his name. And we kept saying, Camille, why are you going to just put Abram? Why don't you say Abram? No, it's going to be Eliah Abram. Eliah Abram. Eliah Abram. Like, come on, come on. He got changed. His name got changed to Abraham. No, it's going to be Eliah Abram. You've been prayed on. people, you don't know the testimony.
Right.
But his mother was my best friend.
Amen.
She died when he was 18 months old. It was this ministry's duty to raise those kids. Even though others did everything they could to pry, to hinder. And I'm supposed to take this lightly? I'm just supposed to turn the other cheek? You have people who have a hardness of heart. Saints, listen up. Let's get here. You ready? The Bible is very explicit. Ooh, y'all ready? Yahweh says, I'm going to harden Pharaoh's heart so that I can make my name great. For no other purpose. In other words, Yahweh says, I have vessels of honor and dishonor just to make my name great. Yahweh's using some people in this church who hate us just for one purpose, just to make his name great. Something. We're going to study on real quick. Give me one. What time is it? 12 what? Oh, run out of time. But listen, let me hear it. Man, if I wasn't saved, I'd run from you. Like, he wanted to beat me up. But when you study the word, I want to read very quickly. What the Bible shows is that when you harden your heart, it builds a character. Yahweh did 10 miracles, 10 plagues.
Right.
When you study the word, the first 5 miracles, Pharaoh hardened his own heart. The last 5, Yahweh hardened for him. You ready? You ready on the bed? You ready? You ready, Eli? There are some people in the fivefold ministry, Yahweh's going to harden their heart against the name Yahweh Yahshua, just so we can teach the masses. Yeah. 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 Yahweh's gonna harden their heart for no other purpose than what he told Moshe, I'm gonna harden Pharaoh's heart to make my name great.
Amen.
Just because of that. I'm gonna harden his heart so I can perform every miracle I plan to do.
Amen.
In other words, Yahweh has vessels of honor and dishonor, but it doesn't make a difference if you're a vessel of honor or dishonor. Yahweh's gonna use you for his glory, and he's gonna use you for his name's sake. Hallelujah. Once again, hallelujah. Verse 1 says, and Yahweh said unto Moshe, see, I made thee an Elohim to Pharaoh, and Aaron thy brother shall be thy prophet. Thou shalt speak all that I command thee, and Aaron thy brother shall speak unto Pharaoh, and he shall send the children of Israel out of his land. Verse 3, and I will harden Pharaoh's heart and multiply my signs and my wonders in the land of Egypt. Yahweh will harden hearts to multiply his miracles. Verse 4, but Pharaoh shall not hearken unto you, that I may lay my hand upon Egypt and bring forth my armies and my people, the children of Israel, out of the land of Egypt by a great judgment. Verse 5, and the Egyptian shall know, everyone say the Egyptian shall know.
And the Egyptian shall know.
That I am Yahweh.
I am Yahweh.
Understand that what Yahweh's doing, he's showing other people that I am Yahweh through us. Are you with me? Hallelujah. He's showing other people, hallelujah, through us that I am Yahweh. I mean, are you with me, saints? I want you to hear this. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible's very explicit, hallelujah, that Yahweh hardened Pharaoh's heart. Yahweh causes Pharaoh to be stubborn, then pushes him from his stubbornness. Amen? But we have to understand that the first 5 plagues, Pharaoh hardens his own heart. The last 5 plagues, Yahweh hardens his heart. Amen? Listen, when you keep doing something, hallelujah, with your soul, it becomes your character. I want to read it again. When you keep doing something with your soul, it becomes your character. Pharaoh shows, hallelujah, that he never sold the slaves anything more than slaves. Some of you don't understand what I'm saying. In other words, you have to understand, when you're coming from a master-slave mentality, Pharaoh always saw them as slaves. Because he always saw them as slaves, Hallelujah. The first five times he hardened his own heart, he's like, why should I allow my property to go free? He's already viewed them as a slave. Amen. But then when the miracle started to take place, hallelujah, now Yahweh's hardened his heart because Yahweh has a book to write. Amen. Yahweh has a story to tell. Amen. I need you with me in the name of Yahshua. Because I want you to hear what Dr. Fromm said. Fromm, that's F-R-O-M-M. You listening? Every evil act tends to harden a man's heart. I'm going to read it again. Every evil act tends to harden a man's heart that it becomes deadened to him. In other words, a sin that you are familiar with, you keep doing that sin because it's familiar, and then it becomes habit. Some people walk out of hardness of heart because it is habit. Some people walk out of hardness of heart because that's how they protect themselves. If I feel you're going to hurt me, I put up this shield. I'm hardening my heart. So I don't want you to hurt me anymore, so I put up this shield. I'm hardening my heart. But it comes out, now it becomes a part of their character. That they automatically harden their heart. You don't even have to say nothing. Like, uh-oh, I know they're going to try to come. Come on, come on, protect me. Is your head plant healed yet? Oh, get on up here, girl. Amen. Oh, you let me know. Amen. So you harden your heart. Now, why are you hardening your heart? You're hardening your heart because I don't want you to hurt me. Amen. So here it is, I'm hardening my heart. But after a while, it becomes habit. What we know from the word is because Pharaoh always hardened his heart and he always changed his mind. I'm going to let the slaves go. I'm not going to let them go. I'm going to let the slaves go. I'm not going to let them go. It became habit. So Yahweh knew that he was going to harden his heart. But a lot of times people harden their heart for protection. Here it is that they're hardening their heart. They want to be protected. But what they fail to realize is when you harden your heart, Yahweh's word can't get in. Unless his word is Hebrews 4:12, sharper than a double-edged sword, whereby it cuts asunder even the soul and the spirit. In other words, Yahweh's word is so sharp, it goes directly to the heart. So when I'm on Facebook, I mean, I don't even go to the filters. I just bust right out and go straight to the heart. I'm called insensitive. I'm called arrogant. I'm insensitive, I'm arrogant, I'm mean, but my ministry ministers to the heart. If I minister to the heart, I don't have no time to deal with this shield, this force field you put up. I've got to go straight directly to the source in the name of Yahshua. I'm moving directly at the source. Come on, come again. I'm moving directly at the source, you know? Boom. You just come right to the source in the name of Yahshua. I want to read it again in the name of Yahshua. I'm going to let you go soon. Dr. Fromm wrote, every evil act tends to harden a man's heart that it is dead into. Every good deed tends to soften it. It makes it more alive. The more a man hardens their heart, the less freedom they have.
Yes, that's true.
You ready to hear this? I need you to listen. The more a man hardens their heart, the less freedom they have to change. Because it becomes the habit to harden your heart. So if Elijah doesn't feel loved, hallelujah, he will surround himself by other people that he believes loves him. Or if Elijah feels hurt, Elijah will surround himself by other hurt people because maybe these hurt people can love him. Or if Elijah does not feel that he fits in here with people in the assembly, he will fit in with people who left the assembly, though he might not know why they left. But regardless of what he does it for protection. Come on. Now, as he does have protection, and let us remember that he is a minor. I don't care who you are, there's certain things you can't do to a minor that you do to an adult, or you go to jail. So, as a minor, he will try to protect himself or shield himself because he wants to shield himself from hurt. But yet, he's going to do things under his own understanding. But then Yahweh comes in and he says, no, I'm going directly to the heart, hallelujah, and I'm going to put you where you belong in the name of Yahshua. Because though you may have a problem with your father, it didn't begin with your father. Your father had a father. And your father's father, princess, had a mother.
Oh, wow.
until 1995 or six. But I knew of his grandmother that he never met. I knew of his grandmother that he never met because his grandmother had a baby boy who was a heroin addict. Your great grandmother had a baby son who was a heroin addict, hallelujah, who spent all his time in New York with needles in his arm.
Come on, Bishop.
And this mother would come and lay by his bed and pray for him, and he would tell her, "Leave me alone." And she would confess that he was going to be a minister and a pastor. And Pastor Herb Green became a minister and a pastor. They only see who they hate.
Yes.
Not recognizing that the person you hate could be tied to your salvation.
Yes.
For me to hate Elijah is to hate my own salvation. When my salvation came in through his great grandmother, whom he never met, who I met through testimony. I think what people fail to understand about ministry is that everyone is connected.
Yes.
I don't care who you are, you can be used for something good if you will just let go of what has caused you to harden your heart. Give me a moment because we're running out of time. Here it is. Go back over there, Pastor Herb Green. Come back over here, Elijah. People harden their hearts because they don't want to hear the word. But once again, the word that we're given in the name of Yahshua, hallelujah, let's turn to Luke chapter 2, verse 11. Don't y'all move. Minister Milano, I need your sons. If anybody knows where his sons are. My goodness. He's going, my goodness. Word ain't go nothing like I planned. Oh, who said that? Go on. Puerto Rico, hey! Man, I love my ministry. I love my ministry. And you know, I don't care who you are, Yahweh comes up against your beliefs. And my father raised me to be a black nationalist. You know, my father come home with power to me. Come on, since I was born in 1966. Amen. My father has a whole different breakdown from the riots in Newark. Totally different from the Bronx, you know. But my father, he was a black nationalist. But my father believed our way out was through education and treating each other with decency and respect.
Amen.
My father didn't believe we could acquire what we were called to acquire by burning our city down. He was very adamant, if you want to protest, why don't you go with somebody else's neighborhood? Why are you going to burn your own neighborhood? He said when they came to burn down the bank, my father, we used to play in the McDonald's on Broad Street. It used to be United States Savings Bank. We used to do cartwheels in there. Know everything because my father worked in there at night. He said when they came to burn the bank, he said, "Look, you brothers don't want to burn this bank. Brothers work here. Burn down the Howard." The Howard was right next door. He said they burned that. He said, "I just called the fire department." But my father raised me to be a black nationalist. And our definition of a black nationalist was to be independent and to raise me to be self-reliant. When I came into ministry, it didn't work. It didn't work in ministry because the people who hurt me the most were blacks. Black males. The people who hurt me the most, warred against me the most, tried to sabotage me, tried to destroy my ministry. Amen. That has never happened. Hallelujah. With the Latino brothers, hallelujah. But Yahweh does things, hallelujah, in order to bring unity. So I'm not forced to have a black faith.
Right. Amen. Amen. Amen.
I'm not forced to have a black faith. Hallelujah. Because I've learned being stabbed in the back. People, for some reason, it's hard for black men to submit to other successful black men. Yeah. They'd rather submit to a thug than another black man. That shit, that, come on, you don't like it? Jump in the lake. I'm not gonna apologize. But I'm very proud of the ministry Yahweh has given me. And I see what Yahweh is doing. I need you with me for a moment. Hallelujah. Very speedily, I'm about to let you go. So you think. Verse 50, verse 25. Behold, there was a man in Jerusalem by the name of Simeon, and the same man was a just and devout man, waiting for the consolation of Israel. The Holy Spirit was upon him, and it was revealed unto him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Adonai Christos. And he came by the Spirit into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Yahshua to do for him after the custom of the Torah, he then took him up in his arms, he blessed Elohim and said, Adonai, now let your servant depart in peace according to thy word. For my eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared from the face of the men, a light to the Gentiles and the glory of thy people Israel. Verse 33, and Joseph and his mother marveled at those things were spoken. And Simeon said, I need you to converse with me. Blessed them and said unto Miriam his mother, behold, this child is set for the fall and rise of the many. So our ministry, it raises people and it casts people down. And for a sign shall be spoken against. We're spoken against. But verse 35, yea, a sword shall pierce through thine own soul. What this ministry does, we pierce through people's souls. Yes. That the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. That is the calling of this ministry. So we do this piercing. Now I'm just going to read this and I got to let you go. We don't have time to go here. But in Hebrews 4:12, when you begin reading Hebrews, hallelujah, and I'm starting to tie all my words together from all weeks. It starts off, let us therefore fear lest a promise of being left us of entering his rest. We don't have the time to go there. All that is Psalms 95. But we're talking about being left out of a promise. And being left out of a promise, verse 11 says, let us labor therefore to enter into the promise, to enter into that rest, lest any fall after the same example of unbelief. So unbelief keeps you out. For the word of Elohim is quick and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing, even the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit. Amen. In other words, the word is so sharp that it comes in and it cuts. Amen. Are you with me? Hold on a second. Oh, you were worthy. Amen. You were worthy. Minister Lawan, come forward. Bring your sons. Hallelujah. Y'all stay right there, please. Hey, you know, just go ahead. Listen, Minister Lawan. Lift your hands. Yes, Yahweh says, I brought you into this ministry and I made you into an evangelist. Yes, but Yahweh says, all four of your sons represent me.
Amen.
Yahweh says, he's supportive of, you know, Yahweh gives me words that I struggle with. Yahweh says, you are a Hebrew. Yahweh says, Issachar, I was the one who had you named Caleb. I was the one who had you named Seth. And I was the one who had you named Ezra. Yahweh says, I was the one who had you name your firstborn. And Yahweh says, your four sons are four branches. Yahweh says, the name of Yahshua is the great name of the Lord. Yahweh says, I called them to be vessels of honor. And Yahweh says, hear the word. I'm making you into a Joe Kennedy. And Yahweh says, I'm building a dynasty out of the Abrams. I'm building a dynasty out of the Abrams. And Yahweh says, because of your prayers, I'm birthing businesses through you. Yes. Yahweh says, I call you a vessel. vessel of honor. I'm going to bless you because Yahweh says my name has sent you forth. And Yahweh says I'm going to continue to bless you as you go through the hard hearts. And Yahweh says in the name of Yahshua, your sons are going to go to the best schools. Yahweh says in the name of Yahshua, start playing out to the new house because I'm losing them to you. Yahweh says the very names of your sons are blessings that are ordained into the earth. And Yahweh says, I'm going to exalt you in a mighty way. Yes, sir. Yahweh says, you belong to me. Yahweh says, you're not a man of titles, but you are a pastor. Yahweh says, you have the heart of a pastor. Yahweh says, not only do you have the heart of a pastor, but you have a heart of order. Yahweh says there's an apostolic anointing within you that is coming out. Yahweh says the love that you have for this ministry is the love that I put within you. And Yahweh says you're going to build. Yahweh says you are answered prayer. Yahweh says I'm going to protect you wherever you go. And I'm going to open up a new door for the wondrous things you have in your heart. Yahweh says your very character ministers to this house. And Yahweh says your character is sent east of Panama to break the hardness of hearts. But Yahweh says you're going to win battles. Yahweh says you're going to win Egyptians. Yahweh says, I said, I will make my name great amongst the Egyptians. Yahweh says you're going to win the Egyptians. In other words, you're going to win the oppressors. Yahweh says those that oppress, you have an anointing to win. Yahweh says your music is going to slay them and catch them up in the noise. Yahweh says in the name of Yeshua, I position you. And I'm going to bless your family. And I'm going to continue to exalt you. In Yahshua's name, amen, amen. Peace of Pergamum. Saints, you stop right there. Don't walk them on. Lift your hands. Yahweh says you come into this house with a different anointing. Yahweh says your different anointing is needed. Yahweh says you have a different way of reaching people. Yahweh says, I don't want you to be like anybody else in the service. Because in your difference, you're going to win people. Yahweh says, there's a tag team there. Yahweh says, some people drop down from the top rope. But then there's others that come by and pick people up. Yahweh says, you have an anointing to pick people up in Yahshua. And they don't understand why they got an elbow in Yahshua. Why you picking them up in Yahshua? But Yahweh says it's all part of my plan. Yahweh says I'm using you in a mighty way. And Yahweh says you are winning people to this house. You are winning people to my name. You're winning people by being different in the name of Yahshua. Yahweh says it's the difference that's going to make the difference. And it's within that difference that this house can be known as great. Yahweh says, continue to do what I sent you to do. Because as you continue to do what I sent you to do, you're going to win the others that they cannot. And in you, my name is going to be magnified and glorified. And I'm bringing a great change in your home. And Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, what you do is another way of breaking down the heart of the heart. And Yahweh says, you are answered prayer. And Yahweh says, walk in the fullness of that answer. In Yahshua's name, amen. I want to call up the Brewster boys. Brewsters! He said, you know, the words that I give out in service, these are words that I get during the study. Amen. Here you go, Brewster 1 and Brewster 2. Amen. He told me Friday, you know, I'm always flexing on him. He told me, I'm a green belt, you're a no belt. I mean, what are you asking me? I'm a green belt, you're a no belt. Lift your hands. Yahweh said there's anointing upon you from your father and your grandfather. Yahweh says you belong to me. Yahweh says you're going to do great and mighty feats. Everything you do, you're going to prosper in. Yahweh says my favor is upon you. You're going to be the talk of the land, the talk of the state. Yes, the Father, right now I magnify you, Father. I thank and praise you for the legacy that's within them. I thank and praise you for the Brewster legacy. I thank and praise you for the Gregory legacy. I thank and praise you for the Purnell legacy. I thank you, praise you, Father. Hallelujah. Father, right now, we thank and praise you, Father, that these two mighty giants, for they are giants, Father, Father, we say, Father, they're going to bring great honor to their parents, Father, y'all, and great honor to your name.
Yes,
Yahweh says your life has been planned out.
Yes.
You were prayed in before you were born in.
Yes.
Yahweh says you were prayed in through your grandfather. Yes, sir. Yahweh says your grandfather reached down with a smile, not just a smile, whereby it's written in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1, having so great a cloud of witness, let us run the race that is set before us. Father, right now, I thank you and praise you for that cloud of witnesses, Father. That cloud of witness, Father, God, that still, Father, I praise over them today. Father, right now, I say to them, they're going to fulfill their calling. I say they're going to fulfill their duty. But Yahweh says you're going to bring great honor to my name and great honor to this house. And Yahweh's name, amen. It's very important for you to know, Deacon Dominic, Minister Webb, Pastor Jonathan, Renee, amen. It's very important for you to know, hallelujah, that you're a vessel of honor where Yahweh has positioned you.
Yes.
And what I meditate on, and I'm very bold, I'm very, very bold. I believe everybody who wants to hinder somebody in this ministry, you need to leave.
Yes.
I also believe this. If your family doesn't want you coming here, don't come.
Yes. Amen.
I come from a loving family. If my family told me not to go somewhere, I wouldn't go. If you come from a loving family and your family does not want you here, don't come. Because you bring disgrace to the house.
Right.
It is not my job to win your family. If you can't win your family, you make all of us look stupid.
Yes, right, right.
You'll be doing me a favor by not coming. Because the ministry that I'm in warfare comes to me. People accuse me. People accuse me of brainwashing people. Prove to them that you're not brainwashed by not coming.
Right.
I mean, it's not my job to convince your family that you're not brainwashed.
Right.
Are you listening to me? Right. Mr. Ron, Yahweh says, you are a very smart man. I need you to hear what Yahweh says. A degree is not going to make you smart. You are a very smart man. Yahweh says you are a very educated man. Yahweh says stop trying to validate yourself. I already validated you. I need you to hear me, Minister Ron. You getting a degree is not going to impress nobody but you. But Yahweh says, make millions of dollars and people will be impressed. Yahweh says, if you want to impress people, be successful in what I call you to do. If you want to impress people in the name of Yahshua, be the head and not the tail. If you want to impress people, then be the overcomer. If you want to impress people, buy your mother a mansion. If you want to impress people, move your brother into a new neighborhood. If you want to impress people, become a greater blessing to your wife and her family. Yahweh says, stop trying to validate that which I already validated. It's like trying to get an ordination after I already ordained. Yahweh says, stop looking down on wrong. I will hold it against you. Don't look down on my servant. Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, Hezekiah, remove the hurt around your heart. Remove what used to happen when people used to call you names. Yahweh says, that's a thing of the past. It's dead. Yahweh says, you're a man. Yahweh says, you're my man. Yahweh says, you're going to bring great honor to this house. Yahweh says, you're going to win great and mighty souls to this house. And you're going to do it for my name's sake, because I'm giving you an anointing to break hardened heart. And Yahshua's name, amen. Pastor Jonathan, Yahweh says, I'm sending new prosperity to your family. Yahweh says, Issachar, you're going to fill this house with loving souls. Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, I am with you in the name of Yahshua. My word is within you. Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, I'm going to give you new confidence in your writing. Yahweh says, you have to work on your writing in the name of Yahshua, because your writing is going to work on your books. Father, right now, I call them confident, I call them mighty, I call them strong in the name of Yahshua. Friend in my pocket, please stand up. Yahweh says, I've given you. She said, hold that, man. Messing up my flow. Yahweh says, I called you an entrepreneur.
Yes.
Yahweh says, your second book is coming out, but your third book is going to make you great. Yahweh says, your third book is going to make you great. Yahweh says, in the name of Yeshua, you have an entrepreneur anointing, an entrepreneur spirit that's going to sweep this house. Yahweh says, you're going to connect. And the connection that you're making is a path that other people are going to follow. Y'all said many people came to this house promising to do things and they did nothing. Y'all said they couldn't do nothing because they were too strung up in their sexual sin. And y'all said, you're going to do it. You're going to make it happen. And y'all said, my Lord, can I be you are a vessel of honor, a vessel of power, a vessel of might, a vessel of strength, and go forth in my glory. Yes, Lord. Dominic, in the name of Yahshua, lift your hands. Lift your hands with me. Yahweh says, I call you a defender of the house. Yahweh says, he said, well, others fell, he said, cut up all that you're going to excel. Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, you are a multi-millionaire. Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, it's in your heart to bless the bishop. And Yahweh says, not only are you going to bless the bishop, you're going to bless the whole house. Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, I'm putting you on every magazine cover. Yahweh says, it is done. Yahweh says, you ain't paid the man. Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, your brother is going to serve you. Your brother is going to serve you. Your sister is going to serve you. Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, because you made the hard choice. Yahweh says, I exalt you. Yahweh says, you're a man of honor, a man of strength, a man of victory. Yahweh says, defend this house. Your name is the Lord. Yahweh says, just let go and be. Just let go and be. Because Yahweh says, Issachar, you walking in your prophetic calling is going to cause your mother to join this ministry. Yahweh says, your mother's coming to Ben-Hashem Yahweh. Yahweh says, Ben-Hashem Yahweh is a family ministry. But what turns family off is sin. Your sin will kill your anointing. Your sin will kill your anointing for your family. Yahweh says in the name of Yahshua, it says, pick up your prophet anointing and your mother's coming. Yahweh says, once your mother comes, your siblings are coming. Yahweh says in the name of Yahshua, your siblings are coming. Yahweh says, you need your mother and your siblings in order to win your children. Yahweh says you need the whole family in order to win your children. Yahweh says, Isa, I'm giving you a mandate in the name of Yahshua. Yahweh says, no longer putting on a heart of hurt. But Yahweh says, put on a heart of joy, a heart of strength, a heart of miracles and wonders. In Yahshua's name, amen. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Heavenly Father, I magnify you. Yahweh is giving you a ministry. Yes, you have a ministry and a fire within you. Yahweh says, in the name of Yahshua, you're going to speak my word. Yahweh says, Issachar, you're going to speak my word and show forth my glory, show forth my might. Yahweh says, I'm sending the healing all throughout your body. Yahweh says, Issachar, as you speak my name, you're going to see miracles. You're going to see wonders performed. Father, right now, I thank and pray that her very home is a hedge of protection. I thank and pray now in the name of Yahshua that your glory and your grace is forever upon her. And Father, right now, I call her strengthened in you. In Yahshua's name, amen. Saints, give me a minute. She's going away to Spelman, right? When? She was the first baby in the ministry. Amen. She's the first baby ever seen. I had to stop spanking her, it just didn't work. She spanked me, she was like, that's all you got? We have a great love for Camille's kids. We have a very, very great love for Camille's kids. And I want you to listen to me, Camille's kids. And I want you to listen dearly in the name of Yahshua. I was very hurt when your mother died because there were people in the ministry who let your mom down because they did not report that your mom was sick.
Amen.
So you got to understand, hallelujah, I've always had a battle with people in the house in the name of Yahshua. I've always had a battle with people. I don't care if you're going to have vessels of honor and dishonor. This is my house. I can talk about it in the name of Yahshua. But you've got to understand there are people who have a hatred for you because they have a hatred for your father and they have a hatred for me. When people have a hatred for somebody, if you can't attack the person, you're going to attack who they are. But Yahweh is making provision.
Amen.
You guys have to toughen up. Listen to me. Y'all listen to me?
Yeah.
Toughen up and realize you have a history.
Yeah.
People come after your history. History begins before you. If you heard the prayer of the Brewster boys in the name of Yahshua, they have a history over a grandmother and a grandfather they never met. That's a history, that's a lineage. All of us came from somewhere.
Right. Amen.
But we came from people who prayed.
Yes.
Who fasted.
Yes.
And for a lot of us, our lives are easier because someone prayed and fasted.
Amen.
But we can pray for you and fast for you. And because of that, you have people who wanted to rip you from family when you already had family.
Right.
I was there in the name of Yahshua when we didn't know what we were going to do. You see, saints, my ministry's been through death. You know how hard it is for someone to die, and I've got to make phone calls and let everybody know that she's dead.
Yeah.
Amen. Only 30 years old. That's hard to do.
Teach.
That's very hard to do. And then for people to think she died because I minister in the name of Yahweh.
Come on, Bishop. Yes. Come on, Bishop.
For people to believe she died because we didn't preach Jesus. You don't forget stuff like that.
Right.
Stuff is ingrained in
you. Yeah.
I take it personal when you come up against me and what I feel.
Right.
I take it personal when you come up against me. I seriously want you to be honest. You need to learn the story. You need to learn where we come from. You need to know. You need to know. Sacrifices were made.
Amen.
Come on. You know what it is like to walk down the street.
Come on now.
And everybody's saying you're going to hell for sinning in Yahshua.
Come on, Bishop.
Come on. That's the way it used to be for us.
Yes.
On Broadway Market.
Yes. Come on. Yes.
We used to pray on Broadway Market, and Christians would interrupt our prayers and say, they're leading you in error.
Come on, Bishop.
There's a history behind it. But I choose not to walk in my hurts.
Amen.
You gotta know there's a history behind who you are. And that's what's so sad about a lot of people in the inner city. You've got to know there's a history behind you.
Yes.
It's not just you. Somebody prayed for you.
Yes.
Somebody loved you.
Yes.
Somebody lived so you could live.
Yes.
Somebody fought so you could live.
Yes.
Somebody made a sacrifice.
Yes.
And when you remember those sacrifices, then you have a greater respect for your life.
Yes.
You have a greater respect for your calling.
Amen.
Father, right now, we say, honey, what you began in your dream. You're going to see through to them. Father, I say their eyes will be open to every person who's against them. Every person who comes as a friend, Father, and is acting a thief. Who comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Father, I say whoever's not for the greens is against the greens. And not just one green, I say all the greens. Father, I just don't like Marissa. I just don't like Elijah. I like all of them. I even like Asa. And Saba. And Negus. Father, we like all the greens, Father, because we say all the greens are one green. Father, the same thing we pray for those, we pray for the over fat. Father, we pray for cookies. Father, we pray for every green, Father, in the name of Yahshua, so that no greens will be lost. Father, we say no greens are our enemies, Father, all greens are our friends, because we will call them like families. And I say that this family is going to be mighty in this house, great in this house, bold in this house, one in this house. Brother, saved in this house, sent in this house, predestined in this house, in Yahshua's name, amen. Listen, sir, I know I said you too much. The Holy Spirit has something for you, brother. You have a good heart, man. You have a good heart. And the Heavenly Father says, I see what you do. And I see the intent of your heart. Amen. You know, some people, they want to talk about how you failed in the past. But as I said, it's not about what you did in the past. It's about what you hope for in your now. You always hope for better. You always wanted better. And even though you did wrong in your own eyes for life. Because you wanted to meet a need. You wanted to meet a family need. But then as I said, through all of that, I kept you. Through all of that, I saw your love. I saw your good intentions. I saw your good motives. And because of that, I didn't allow people to bring down on what they wanted to bring down on you. I didn't allow whatever decree wanted to go down because I wanted my grace to be sufficient for you. I wanted you to know that through it all, I loved you, and I was making a way of escape for you, because you have a purpose in this life. I know. Come on up here, Anthony. We're about to dismiss. Kind of looking at me like, go on, do that Harlem shake real quick. Anthony got married yesterday. Did y'all know his name is Tony? Anthony came to the ministry when he was 11. I told him, tell people 10, it sounds better. But he used to round up his brothers, put them in the van with Ivan, and come to church faithfully. Had sleepovers. Elder Steve was in charge of sleepovers. How many brothers you got? Four brothers. And I've always known him to take care of his mother and father. Always. He's always been, he like never had a childhood to me. You know, you're Michael Jackson, you don't even know it. Okay, now I'm gonna get personal. His wife is right there. I'm not about her. I don't want you, little, you can throw a punch. Not you. But you know, he always took care of his family. So he would come by the house, Bishop, I need to borrow some money. You borrow some money, you always borrow money. And he's a truck driver. I don't know if y'all know truck drivers are in short demand. Well, make a long story short. I was like, look, man, you know, you always take care of your family, but it's time to take care of you. Since he moved to Georgia. He moved to Georgia, that's how he met his beautiful wife. But it's such a blessing when your life is attached. You never know how you influence other people. When he called me and said he wanted me to marry him, it blessed me. Amen. It really did. Amen. Amen. You know? But you're a fighter, Anthony. And you've never been a quitter. I've always known you to meet needs. But you have an anointing of love on you. And that anointing of love is going to build a family of great, mighty love. And Yahweh says, continue to go in the love. Because it's the love that's my teacher's name, and it's the love that makes sure that's my keeper's name. I can remember when he prayed to get his son, to get custody of his son. He has full custody of his son. Everyone, I gotta let y'all go because we usually don't stay this late. But I'm like high, you know? Let me tell you why I'm high. I slept last night. I slept for 3 hours. But I said all that to say this. Saints, all of us can be vessels of honor. And all of us, I don't care who you are, we're connected to somebody. I was so blessed by Ebony. Ebony took a selfie with my wife. Amen. God bless me, Ebony. She got married and didn't even invite us. Didn't I, Ebony? Yeah, I mean, I'm just me. I'm like, yup, I'll tell everybody to take like, we got, she didn't even invite us. You know, her husband grew up in the church. They didn't invite us out, you know? But the thing is, I know that Yahweh called you to this house.
Amen.
And you know when Yahweh called you to the house, if you can't leave. That's when you know you really fan. But what I need you to know is this. Let's stop hardening our heart from what we truly know we need and allow the Holy Spirit to come in and make that difference. All right, lift your hands, y'all. I've been talking too long. Look, Elder Steve, he's so happy. Look, I got called in front of you. Even niggas laughing, look. Heavenly Father, right now, I thank you and praise for all the love in this house. Father, I don't apologize for the long service because I believe people were blessed. Father, I say that everyone here belongs. Every single soul here belongs. And Father, I say for the we belong because we're family. And Father, I say for the family is going to get along. And family's going to get together. Father, right now, I say we're not going to harden our heart to protect ourselves from one another. But Father, we're going to allow your word to come in and fix whatever has to be fixed. We refuse to be found. And because of this, I say everything that happens is for the glorification of your name. And Father, we lose all these blessings in Yahshua's name. Amen. This ain't before you need to teach my love to my life. All right, do the right thing, Father.